my career is kind of very interesting because when I was in high school, I wanted to be an engineer, you know, not biologist. But accidentally, I went to, you know, a university to study biology and eventually came to Australia and joined the CSIRO. And that's where I started sort of virus research. And so for the last 10 years or so, you know, we have been really successful in leading this area of research internationally. So Hendra virus was the first really high lethal virus. And through our collaboration with the Queensland people, and we discovered that it actually originated from bats. And so the OCE Science Leader Program provided us to start to research into bats. And that has led to many important discoveries of how bats may be different from other mammals, and which will have a real impact on our understanding how to prevent bat viruses. And also, bats are long-living mammals, so we can learn from them about longevity and their ability to combat cancer and other diseases. For viral outbreaks, you know, when they happen, usually it's very quick and acute. So when they emerge, you know, everybody is asking why, you know, can you do this, you know, in a short time? And so funding is not an issue. But this kind of outbreak, as I said before, does not happen very often. So we compare this kind of a disease outbreak almost like a wartime. You know, you're fighting the emerging infectious disease. It's very rapid, high, you know, mortality, sometimes a lot of deaths. And so during wartime, you know, we have all the resources and try to combat the disease. But during non-outbreak time or peacetime, we found it's very difficult to attract attention and funding. So that's, I think, is one of the major challenges. So a more efficient strategy is try to prevent them. And the best way to prevent them is to do surveillance, and so that we can know their sort of outbreak in a very early stage, and so you have early detection, early warning. I think the OCE Science Leader really helped our research in many different aspects. I think the first one of them is really the opportunity to perform science, you know, with the freedom operation, you know. And so looking at my career, so I started from not liking this area to now I'm really enjoying contributing to the science, but more importantly, save lives and increase the biosecurity of Australia.